Welcome to the Wealth Transfer, where global economics, biblical principles, and protecting and preserving your family is paramount. And let's just say protecting and preserving the kingdom's wealth, even just as paramount, if we're going to be here for one another. I am Terry Sacka, Chief Strategist. I'm along with Dr. Charles Vance. Charles, how's it going today?
Terry, it is doing great. Glad to see you today. Always great to be on the program.
Are you relaxed this time?
You were the one last week, man. You were like on the edge. You were like, no, I'm fine.
You
I have a leash on you, maybe.
I was thinking, I'm seeing people are going to turn off the TV, man. You start yelling at them like that, right?
Yeah, you weren't yelling at the people.
No.
You were just, I call it fervent. You got a fire burning in you. Yeah. And I'd like to see it stir up some people, quite honestly. I mean, I don't know what to do as a pastor and a public speaker,
is that kind
conference
of the
speaker.
Thing?
Yeah, it comes with the same thing. I mean, you think,
feel that sometimes they don't listen. Oh, and
well, you just want to get it to them somehow, and sometimes you just don't know how to get the information. Sometimes you think, the louder I talk, the more they'll get, and it's not always necessarily true. But we do have a fervent message on this program. It's a program, really, that you didn't want to do, and I've mentioned this several times.
Yes, all those people that say, look at this guy doing this, say, hey, he made me do it.
You know, you could tell them that. I'm fine. Because when we really started this program, before we started it, my wife and your wife and me and you sat down in a house in Florida that we had rented for some vacation
Orlando,
time.
Yeah.
And I said, listen, people need to know what you know. They don't know. Most people don't know what you know. And it's important. When God gives us some revelation concerning things, it's important that we share it. That's why we do our television program, Empowered, is because we believe we have some education or some revelation on the Word of God that we want to share. You have deep revelation concerning the financial situation, I almost say crisis, that's going on in the earth today and in the world today, and there almost is a financial crisis that is going on.
Apocalypse,
okay, an unveiling.
An unveiling to truth.
So anyway, today we want to get into some things that really just unveil some more truths so that people can make educated decisions. If they don't have the truth, if you don't have truth, you can't make an educated decision. So it's important to us that you get the truth.
I agree. And, you know, we did talk last week. We were talking about why we're mentioning silver. We're saying people, you know, why do we believe this? It's silver. Number one, we said it was biblical. You know, and I do like Job 27. You know, the rich will pile up silver like dust. And it goes on to say, but in the end, it'll be distributed to the innocent. And I like that because silver is always money. And the rich always piled up money. But the beautiful thing is, our great banking system has fooled people. And instead of piling up biblical money that they should have always piled up, they now pile up the rich, pile up this fake stuff. And so what's interesting about Job 27, when it goes on to say, but then it'll be distributed to the innocent. I believe the innocent's we in the body of Christ. And why I think it's going to be distributed to us is because if we in the body of Christ stay firm with biblical principles, which is real money, God's money, hey, guy, 2 weights, silver's mine. And, of course, you know, a dishonest weight and measure is an abomination. Honest scales are a delight. This is honest because 1 ounce is 1 ounce. And I believe when this fake system, dishonest weight and measure, collapses, the apocalypse, which means the unveiling, takes place, the truth will set us free and we will have a wealth transfer because this will have maintained value, and then, as Job goes on to say. So I like that because what we've found is a lot of folks say, oh, yeah, I saw silver go up to $50 back, you know, not too long ago, a few years ago, and then it came down. Oh, boy, not doing very good, is it? And they like to try to stick it to you, you know. Oh, boy, good job. Look at silver. I'm like, you just have no idea. And so what I'd like to do, Charles, is I'd like to start by showing a graph that is so vividly clear as to why that happened and help people understand, because they did it for a reason, and the reason was to fool we the people that everything was going to be okay. Because remember, if silver had gone higher than 50 and gold higher than 2000, the world would have known that our economy was collapsing, the dollar was no good, which still kind of is, and they had to stop it. So they started selling these naked shorts and such. Now, keep in mind, although I know that this financial apocalypse is real and coming, we're always going to use dollars. The U.S. dollar is not going away. down the road, in the near future, who knows how long, 10, 15, 20 years, it will be the Chinese yuan. And wait to see the stuff we're getting into over the next few weeks on that. But the dollar's going to be around. What I'm trying to say is we're going to lose our reserve elite status. We're going to lose the petrodollar arrangement where every country needs to hoard this in their central banking system as reserves. And that kind of action will force the value of paper to go down dramatically. And in the process, of course, this goes up substantially, and we have a transfer of wealth as the systems of the world kind of realign, and the rich, you know, end up in the dust.
Yeah, Terry, the currency system is not something that is just a simple exchange. It's something that has been invented by some very, very intelligent people.
Luciferians.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that's just people that's gonna be, are governed
I'm
by the world.
I'm on that one because it, I'm definitely, that is, yeah. It,
the God of this world, yes. It's a world system that operates this system.
Yes.
It's definitely not a God system because you've already said it. Real silver, real gold is what God calls currency. Yep. It's in the scripture.
Hey, guy, 2-8.
So,
yeah.
So there is a... This manipulation of this, people are learning how to do it because they have been trained how to do it.
That's
by the
right.
Federal Reserve banking system.
That's
which
right.
is our banking system here in America.
Right.
And now...
Now, remember, those central bankers are all over the world now, so it's... You know,
exactly.
It's not
but
just
the
United
weren't.
States. But.
They weren't.
No, we created that.
We created
the
it.
The Western world did,
and
yeah.
we created a slick system.
Yes, we did.
I shouldn't say we, the banking system, Federal Reserve mm-hmm. banking system... Other people are starting to copy it now. They're not going to sit around and let us have control of this
no.
when it's all a fake system anyway.
Right.
So you got some people kicking in and doing some stuff that our guys have been doing, and now it's taken credibility away
yes.
from this, but it's also taking value away from this.
The most important part, it's taking value. Now, what is value? Buying power.
Mm-hmm.
Buying power. What can this buy you? Don't get caught up in the lawyer, accountant, financial advisor that says the simplest narrative. It sounds like education 101 narrative. When they say, oh, but gas is coming down. Things are great. Gas coming down is because things are not great. Things are really bad. And everything else is still expensive because I don't know about you, but groceries and clothing and batteries and everything else are still really expensive and they don't seem to be coming down. Airline tickets seem twice as much money. So, I mean, come on. And what does it buy you? And so the point is we save these and we have what for buying power? As an individual, as a ministry, as a church. What do we have to spread the gospel, feed the poor, if we're hoarding these instead of what God told us to hold, which was this? I just think most people never knew how. They always thought of it as junk silver, like jewelry.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't know how. What do I do? What do you take it? Do you go to a bank? What do they do? So there obviously is very simple ways in doing it. That's kind of part of the education system. But more importantly, just to understand that it has always been constitutional, biblical, real money. And so we're going to show you some things here after this little announcement so you can have a better understanding as to why it happened. But let's just take this. This price coming from 50 to where it is today is a gift to the body of Christ because it really deserved to go a lot higher. I thank God for the manipulation right now. I just do. Because for those who have not been able to take advantage with their IRAs or retirements or savings and get properly positioned in real tangible assets, you have a chance to do it while you could buy a lot more. So it's wonderful. So the best way to, you know, really get started, get an education. And remember, you don't have to go here if you don't want to, although we're a good Judeo-Christian seed to sow. So here's a good way to get started.
Cornerstone Asset Metals is here to help you protect and preserve what you have worked hard to gain. For those who have IRAs to protect, 401ks to preserve, or cash in the bank, we would like to send you a package of information regarding the changes to the dollar and the challenges of our economy that you need to be prepared for. This package includes how easy it is to roll over your current IRA or 401k into a physical precious metals IRA for long-term protection of your hard-earned wealth. For those of you with cash to invest, we can arrange to have your precious metal stored in a private vault or simply send it to your home. Call or register now.
Okay, Charles wanted to show how real it was by banging this and this. This was going to flap, but I told him if we do this, we'll break the glass because it's actually real.
We can make a little noise with it.
It's tangible. It's real. And this is the whole point here, protecting our assets. So let me jump into this, Charles. This is good stuff. But this is known as the silver ETF. Now, I'm not an ETF fan. ETF really just means exchange-traded funds. It's a paper trade, a paper way to buy silver. A lot of financial advisors, bankers, accountants, they cannot buy physical silver and gold. Now, mind you, number one, because the government makes it so they can't.
That who can't? Banking,
brokers,
the system
broker can't? Systems. They make it so they
like
can't.
Like the stock market.
Yeah.
Okay.
And it's interesting how, and mainly like money managers, pension funds and people, they really technically can't, and they try to make it very difficult for them. So what they do is they create these things called ETFs.
Okay.
ETFs is an exchange-traded fund. All of this is paper way of buying gold and silver.
Okay.
And then they talk to people into, hey, you want to buy gold and silver? Buy the ETF. So look at
now,
this.
What do you end up buying when you do that? Are you just buying like a stock?
You're buying a piece of paper that says you own interest in the price going up and down of silver. But you don't physically own it. Nope.
Well, that's crazy.
Well, yeah. But you gain or lose as the price goes up and down. So basically it's like
so
a
it's
gamble.
It's stock.
It's gambling.
Yeah, okay.
It's gambling because it's paper. It's not real. It's not buying the real physical tangible asset.
Right,
it's just a piece of paper.
This always has trading value. When
always
you own
has
it.
Trading value.
Yeah.
You try to give me a piece of paper, I'm going to say I'm going to want it unless I can light a fire with it. Right. So they talk people. They did last time around when it was running, the price is running. They were talking people into buying these ETFs.
Running, you're talking about going up.
Going up, yes. Okay. And prices are going up. So here's the actual chart I want to get to. Now, this silver ETF is so clear and obvious from just our backdrop. You can get it. This is versus coin and bar demand, physical. So the green and the yellow you see is the actual ETF, and the blue is the coin and bar form. Now, on the left side here, we see that this is 2006 to 2010. This is when we kind of had that big crisis going on between the real estate.
Sure.
Of course, we had then the market crash in 2008. Yeah. So gold and silver ran pretty good. We were printing money, but those were when we had the QEs. As you can see, most people invested in the ETFs on the left there, and coin and bar form was there, but they were about equal. So the smart people bought the physical, even though they bought it, even if at higher prices, never sold it, who cares, it's going back. Then you could see, though, they equally split. But this is what's unique I wanted to share. Look at the right side. The right side shows what to the ETF? Nothing. Literally nothing.
And that's going on
right now.
Right now.
This is current. This is today.
So
current.
People are
look
making
at the blue.
Decision.
Look at the blue. Literally by the tonnage, you're seeing, this is millions of ounces, by the way, you're seeing people wise up. And currently today, since 2011, when the prices started coming down by those naked, manipulated shorts,
mm-hmm.
what the bankers had intended to do was scare people away from gold and silver. And what if you notice what they've done, they drove people away from the fake paper and into the actual real physical.
Well, thank God people are wising up to that.
Amen, brother, because that what you've seen is since that price drop, you've seen literally almost a billion ounces of silver bought up in the system, 900 some million ounces.
So
remember, there's not that much
purchased
even,
by individuals or companies.
Yes.
Or banks.
Yes.
Banks can't buy it?
They don't, no.
They don't.
It's a, oh my gosh,
yeah.
That's like, yeah.
I mean, it'd be like doing something wrong.
Yeah,
because
it'd be like really doing something
like
wrong,
that.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
I can only
okay,
imagine that one. You
yeah.
know, you go to a bank, oh, you can't, bless their hearts, they don't know anything anyway. But no, yes, it would be really bad. But there's a phenomenal image, because what you've seen is before, people were talked into this price rise by saying, here, buy the paper. But now you see this last time around, everybody's buying the actual physical.
Mm-hmm.
And this is really, really important to understand. Now, and one of the reasons that this has taken place, which I personally like this, people say, well, why is that happening? The economy's getting better. Everything's doing great. Well, is it? Well, you see here, U.S. industrial production.
Mm.
Well, what's interesting about this was doing pretty good there, right? This is January of 2015 on the left. Look, by time we got to the end of 2015, industrial production. You can take that off. I can't make that up. Now, while we were being told by the media, by unemployment's dropping, and this is great, look at how from on the left side to the right, we see from January to the end of the year, negative. Now, what that's telling us, this is industrial production.
And that's meaning U.S. industry producing things.
At the end of, which is no more than a few months ago here, negative. Meaning we're in a massive recession already. They're just lying to us. Mm-hmm. So this is very, very important to get, because people who are wising up and protecting their IRAs and 401ks for the next inevitable financial apocalypse that's coming, this unveiling. And I say that because I love it, because when we see behind the curtain and realize that in the last 7 years, this president has been successfully behind printing more money than all presidents before him. Now, in all fairness, it started in the president before him, but he did a whopper of a job doubling down. Mm-hmm. So we have literally added $10 trillion in fake obligation.
It's near unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. And I don't think the average person can even comprehend $1 trillion.
Yeah,
it's $1,000 billion.
Yeah.
I mean, you have to sit and even think about that.
You know what's even harder, Charles? They can't even comprehend really what that means to us, is $10 trillion and are these obligations. Bottom line is this. Every American, that's every baby, every man, every woman, every child, is obligated, slave obligated to debt of this nation to $75,000 a person. Whether you did anything or not to do it, you owe 75 grand out of your wages.
We really own them, don't we?
See?
They want us to think that they own us, and that the federal land, they can control it.
Yes.
We really own them.
You would think so, right?
They're in debt to us, are they not?
Yes. But they're winning the argument.
They are winning the argument because they make the rules.
They could never win the argument if tens and tens of millions of Americans stood up and said no.
Mm-hmm.
The only reason this is continuing is because nobody really knows what's going on or knows the truth.
People are not educated in this area.
They're not educated at all because the world doesn't want you to be.
Certainly.
So if we go into...
The system wouldn't work if
people were educated. Oh, of course, exactly. And listen, I understand. We're Keynesian economics. We must spend money, not save. That's why they're talking about negative interest rates. That's why they're talking about, you hear, the war on cash. That's why they're trying to say we should tax people or put fines and penalties for saving money, fines and penalties for depositing money. The reason they're afraid of cash is they want to force you to spend it.
Sure.
Well, what a great way to spend it.
Mm-hmm.
Buy this and store it away. If it's not in their bank, they don't have control over you.
Right.
What I'm saying here in this, if it's not in their bank, they don't have control over you. If your retirement is not in their bank or brokerage, they don't control you. We are free people. We were supposed to be. Liberty means freedom, although the Statue of Liberty doesn't mean that through the Masons. It actually means free from God, but that's a whole other conversation. So what we want to get into is understand that we, the people, Christian in the kingdom is what I'm talking about, have an obligation, because we need to be good stewards and managers of what God's given us. And I believe if we are good stewards and managers in the time that is coming, we not only have the resources to help feed the poor, we have inheritance to our children's children, but we have the resources to keep up the fight in the kingdom, in the realm of the United States, to stop this Luciferian, perverted, overbearing, absolutely staunch Marxist socialist agenda to rob and steal your soul. And don't think otherwise if you really knew what it meant. So get protected. Best place to do that? Well, an education. So let's start with this. Here's some information. Do that, and then we'll go from here.
Cornerstone Asset Metals is here to help you protect and preserve what you have worked hard to gain. For those who have IRAs to protect, 401ks to preserve, or cash in the bank, we would like to send you a package of information regarding the changes to the dollar and the challenges of our economy that you need to be prepared for. This package includes how easy it is to roll over your current IRA or 401k into a physical precious metals IRA for long-term protection of your hard-earned wealth. For those of you with cash to invest, we can arrange to have your precious metals stored in a private vault or simply send it to your home. Call or register now.
So the reason this is important to understand is, and we talk a lot about gold and silver because it's constitutional money. So for all the people who say you do it because you manufacture it, well, obviously we manufacture it because we're in God and we manufacture what God gave us as money. But what is important to understand
is... Let me stop you a minute. You used to work for a brokerage house, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. I held a Series 3, 7, 63, 65. I'm still an accredited asset management specialist. And then my 3 was actually in the commodity realm. I understand the financial world. And so, but the reason is I left it because of what was going on.
You made money in that arena.
Yeah, but you know what? I saw how it was a funnel.
Gotcha.
It was all designed.
I'm pointing all this out for a purpose.
Our job was to bring money into the brokerage, to funnel it through to the traders at Wall Street, and they made all the money. If you ever notice, most people in their 401ks and IRAs make a pittance while they do it. Now, I have a wonderful gentleman friend in the last handful of years, 5 years actually, while the market was going up with all the printed money about 100%, he lost 15%. And I'm like, wow, good job there, stockbroker boy.
Wow.
You know?
Yeah.
I was thinking, this is just really funny. Because that's my point. Now, not everyone has that result, but still, come on, right? The reason they did this, as we talk about, is about deception. They didn't want you believing that a real tangible asset, which was a constitutional asset or biblical, was important. And
well,
now,
all
this
you can
is
do
why.
Is buy and sell it, it with equal value.
Yes.
And the other stuff, you can manipulate the value.
You can manipulate the value.
Yeah.
And so you get a very good point. What they didn't want us to know is our goal, China, and we're going to get into this big, China and Iran, and well, mainly China, Russia, and a lot in the Middle East, they're importing massive amounts of gold and silver. They're telling their people to own gold and silver. You have to understand this. This is really important. But we in the West didn't want you to know that because of this image here. This is known as the U.S. gold export and import and mine supply. Now, what that is on the left there is mine supply. Then you have gold imports in the middle. And then you have the big one there, gold exports. You notice we're exporting a lot of our gold. Result for the year 2015, negative. We actually exported more gold than we imported or we mined in our country. And people would say, well, why would we do that? Why would we get rid of all of our gold when everyone else is taking it? We're not technically getting rid of it. We're buying people off. We're giving them the gold to kind of keep them quiet for a little bit. And the East is taking the gold because they're saying, well, they're saying this. Go ahead. You throw us your gold, and we'll throw you some fake paper printed money to make you viable in your deficit spending debt world. China on the left, on the left here, and there we go. We're throwing them our gold, and they're throwing the paper money. And this is the real deal. This is known as a currency war.
Mm-hmm.
And we're in this currency war, which is very, very, very real. And that's why people are trying to understand why would they do this. Now, here's what's going to end up happening. It's coming. The reset's taking place. We're going to have it. It's just taking a little time to play out the game. The dollar's still going to be around, but it's going to be one of a handful. And so you have to understand, China's in this for the game haul. They're in the long haul. I don't personally believe in the massive apocalyptic nuclear war scenarios, although that can happen at any time. China wants it both ways. They want friends on both sides of the fence, and they know in the future they are going to be the dominant currency in the financial system. They are because of population. They've already taken over us as number one in world in trade. They're doing it. So just understand that this is the real deal. And I'll leave you with this. For silver net balance for the last 12, 14 years, take a look at this. Negative, negative, negative. Mm. Every single year for the last 14 years, we have consumed more silver than we produce and we recycle. And really understand what that is telling you. We are consuming more than we're producing and recycling.
There's becoming a shortage of it, obviously.
Then. Yes, there is. And then take a look at this next one, and we'll call it a night. This is the U.S. Mint sold out of their gold coins, and look at the price going down, but yet the sales are going up.
See, they did that.
Hold on, look at this. We're running out, but check it out.
Uh-huh.
The price is going down, but the supply, the demand's going up. That means that's a skewed lie economic data point, because when the demand goes up, price goes up. So
they did it with
it's
silver.
Coming.
They did it with silver at the end of
yes,
the year.
Yes, and it's so. Coming. And wait till you see where we're going with China next week.
Got to be back
God
with
bless
us next
you.
Week. Same place, same time for the wealth transfer. Make sure you catch us on CornerstoneAssetMetals.com as well. We'll see you next week.
Cornerstone Asset Metals has focused on using gold and silver reserves to protect your assets from volatile currencies. Another hard asset that is just as important for your sustainability is food. We believe that preparation is a key to being successful in an unstable economic environment, so we started CAM Ready Food just for you. The Bible tells us that Joseph used the resources of Egypt to prepare for a global famine by storing up food in a time of plenty. His preparation not only preserved the lives of his family, but many others as well. At Cornerstone, we believe the time is now to re-examine this biblical lesson so that you and your family can be prepared for any disaster, job loss, food shortage, or economic instability. You can start preparing today by visiting our website, CamReadyFood.com, because food truly is the ultimate currency. Cornerstone Asset Metals is here to help you protect and preserve what you have worked hard to gain. For those who have IRAs to protect, 401ks to preserve, or cash in the bank, we would like to send you a package of information regarding the changes to the dollar and the challenges of our economy that you need to be prepared for. This package includes how easy it is to roll over your current IRA or 401k into a physical precious metals IRA for long-term protection of your hard-earned wealth. For those of you with cash to invest, we can arrange to have your precious metals stored in a private vault or simply send it to your home. Call or register now.